what's up?
Hanging out?
Yeah, just hanging out on a Thursday in the middle of a, well, almost the middle.
Hey, do you know that Daft Punk was here? Daft Punk?
Participant number one, representing SGC, he is the Corn Belt Cowboy, he is the one, Paul Bender!
For this GCW bonus show, and we're about to see what happens when a corn-fed cowboy walks down the streets and heads to the area where Young, Dumb, and Broke hold court.
Representing Young, Dumb, and Broke, and representing the Punk Star Posse, he is Cowboy Elvis Taylor!
It is about to go down, ladies and gentlemen. Inner city warfare meets corn-fed, cowboy-based violence here in a very special GCW bonus show. Just teeing it up and setting your appetite for the incredible pay-per-view event that is about to go down on Fight TV at the top of the hour. This is your boy KG Kevin Gill, and I am honored to be joined by MLJ. And I would say that I would never do to MLJ what Manders just did to Taylor.
You're one of few. I'm sure many people have done that to me before. I don't think... Exactly. I was about to say, if this gets into a contest of, swinging hands and throwing those ham hock-like fists, I think it might be an early night for Ellis Taylor.
Oh, without a doubt. You know, we know Ellis Taylor. He's young, he's dumb, he's broke. He's got a lot of upward mobility. Wow. Kind of a glancing blow there, but it looks like it still had some effect.
Yeah, he went searching for the dropkick to the back of the head. I wasn't sure if he was going to go for like a double stomp or a dropkick. He just kind of improvised.
And he might have changed his mind halfway through, or fate may have dictated the circumstances.
Yeah, like I don't want to count Ellis Taylor out at all. Hard kick. I mean, I know he's a great young professional wrestler, but if it gets to be a contest, throwing arms, throwing hands, throwing bows.
You can't fight Manders.
It's tough. I mean, he's got heavy hands. You hear it right there.
You can just the strength. Look at this, making it look easy. Just dropping him right on that apron. Manders is one of those guys, too. 2020's been a bitch, but Manders has kept on plugging, kept on moving forward. Quick cover by Manders there, only two.
And Ellis Taylor, you see him trying to get some sense back into the arm, get some feeling back into it. Landed hard on the arm. You know, that is the hardest part of the apron. We are contractually obligated to say that.
And, if you don't say it, you get taken to the local medical facility. Those you get the choices.
And you get blackballed. Wait, what is he going to do here?
No.
Oh, rotation belly to belly. Sort of like Scott Steiner back in the early 90s.
Amazing lower body strength by one called Manders.
Yeah, I was kind of confused because I saw him hook him up for the waist lock, and then he turned around into the corner. I thought he was going to pitch him over the top.
You never know with Manders.
Right. That's a hell of a way to win a match, right? Wow. Chuck somebody over the top. It worked for Mike Awesome.
And now Ellis trying to get into that battle you talked about, a battle, but maybe leading with the foot is more advantageous than leading with the fist against someone like Manders. God damn.
And that's the thing you got to do. Hold on. He's got the cover here. Back press, far leg hook. 2.5 only. But if you're Ellis Taylor, you're going to want to kind of disorient your opponent. You want to come at him from different angles, especially when you're smaller. Oh, come on.
What was that?
Oh, I think he was
he
just
lining
them up.
He was his territory.
Yeah.
He was queuing it up like a DJ cues up a record, MLJ. And now you can see Taylor, a lot of force and a lot of momentum behind those kicks. Not that one, though. He missed it.
Yeah, Manders kind of suckered him in, I think.
Yeah, Manders drew him in and ducked that kick. Don't count the cowboy out. People think because Manders is big and because he's cowboy and corn-orientated that Manders is not smart. But that's for up to someone else to say. I would never say that he's not smart.
Oh!
His wrestling acumen proves his intelligence. But he may have just forgotten a big chunk of what he knew following that kick from Taylor. Taylor! So close.
Yeah, he almost picked up a big win there, did Ellis Taylor. And, man, what an enziguri that was. That connected right on the button.
And you could see that dazed look, which you sometimes see a little about an hour after last call with Manders, but you don't often see it during the match itself.
Yeah, not during the match. He's usually a very game competitor all throughout the contest. But, I mean, that tells you how hard that kick from Ellis Taylor, well, multiple kicks from Ellis Taylor have been.
And great strategy there. Manders holding on to that arm and unleashing all those chops until he went full. That's amazing.
That was like corn-fed Kobashi.
Thank you.
Corn-ta Kobashi. Can I say that?
Corn-fed Kobashi. Or
corn-fed Kobashi.
The corn-fed Kobashi, one cold Manders, knows that 2021 is the year he gets his Ribera jacket and hopefully his first world title. But well, maybe I'm looking too far into my crystal ball, MLJ.
What the hell is he going to do here?
Something fucking
a power
violent.
Slam off the middle? Oh! Ellis Taylor reversed it right off the middle rope there. He's on top to cover the... Oh, man. He came real close. I don't even know what
dude,
to call
that super reversal. Kick right on the button. Taylor could shock the world. Ellis Taylor, where's this coming from?
He's hungry, man. He wants this win in the worst way. You know, Jordan Oliver, he's getting his shine here in GCW. He wants to be just like.
There you go.
Oh, Saito suplex up to his feet, though.
Oh!
And right back down onto his neck. Good
Manders
night.
Showing him how it's done.
Wow. Ran him over like a Mack truck.
The winner of this bout, one call, Manders. Let's go.